show you some adapters for the Rust-Oleum, because these caps, they do a great job if you just want to cover an area. It's very sporadic, it's not very even with these caps. So I'm going to show you this adapter that you can put on these Rust-Oleum cans and maybe other cans. I'm not sure. I don't use any other paint that has a male to female joining system, if you will. Rust-Oleum makes these so that they, I guess, made it to where graffiti artists can't do. Use them with other caps, then they made this, and it helps out a lot. So I'm gonna show you where it's just a normal cap does. Let's see here. We'll shake it up, and I'm just gonna spray just a dot and probably a line. So just to show you the distance. Or your paint might be thin. So you always want to shake it up and then just the line. You can see a little spatter. Very thin in the middle, thick on the outside. Now let's try it with this adapter, and then what we're going to use is the Klaus thin, which is normally known as a German thin. But you want to put your cap on your adapter before you put it on your can, because if you put this adapter on and press down, all that paint's going to come out the top of that, and you're going to ruin your ceiling or whatever you're painting. So do not do that. Put your cap on first. Let it turn. You got to get a little guy here, I guess, it. So your cap doesn't turn. Then you take your adapter. Not pointing at your face, pointing away from your face when you're putting it on, and just press down slightly, or you can just turn it. Just kind of turn it. If it sprays, that's when you know that it's on. So that's why you can point it towards your face. So, and mind you, this is a very high pressure can, and it sprays upside down, you know, so that you can, I don't know how they do it, but that's that can. Spray it a couple times, get that thin paint out of there, and then this is what the German thin does. Yeah, that's kind of far away. So drip, that was about the same distance. Maybe a little closer. You can tell, if you get closer, you're going to get a drip, but it's a little finer. So let's just do a line. It looks a little different, huh? Let's see if it's something. Let's go far out and then close in and see how that looks. Look at that. It looks nice over there, right? A little closer with the normal tip. This normal tip on just to give it up. It's going close. You can do it at the bottom here. A little different. Hold on. big difference in those caps. This is for coverage, pretty much. This, you get a really smooth coverage. This cap. Let's see, we're gonna go ahead. So, let's see what this little mini thing will do. Let's take this off. And I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna try mini thing with this Rust-Oleum. Really close and do it fast, you can get some pretty thin line. Alright, we'll try it on. I have two different kinds here. I have a Molotol Premium. This is light blue. This paint is amazing. I'm going to show you what their cap does, and then when you put a custom cap on it. And also, you have Montana. This is a very high quality paint as well. It's a black label, but I'm going to use purple. Let me use this color. This is violet. You really want to shake this paint up. A lot. I'll show you what the Klaustin does first. This comes with a pretty good cap. I'm pretty sure it's a wide cap, a little fat cap. Always shake up, get out. This is definitely be, watch. It's very light. Shake it up. Let me get you a cap from Molotov first. is what their cap. This is from the yellow. Put it on this light blue. This is nice. This is a very opaque paint, real nice paint. But this is what I'm not pleased about with this particular cap for this paint. It's such a nice paint. With our cap, I'm probably about that close to it. You see that? Pretty sure that's a perfect circle. That is amazing right there. And I'm a good inch, maybe a little less. I'm scared. I'm sure this is a pretty low pressure can. This is called shock blue, by the way, if you're interested in it. My mom told me. I'm pretty sure it's a low pressure. It doesn't seem like it's in a rush to come out. Low pressure, like it is probably impossible to get a drip unless you sit here and spray continuously. That's pretty amazing. That's a good thing right there. What I would like to do is move it over. See if the mini pen goes on. On this low pressure. In the next video, what I'll be showing you is one we call Skinny Boy, which is really pretty skinny. I haven't used it, but I've seen the little diagram that they use, and then we're going to use the Fat Robot Head. That's what I like to call them, Fat Boys. That'll be in the next video. Now we redo this little mini thing. Let's get this a little lower. There you go. You got your adapter. It goes on the Rust-Oleum's. Remember. Always put the cap on first before you put it on this bag. You do not need this for these. For the other cans I've used, just cap directly on it. Just pace it away. Twist until it's a little firm. Start to paint. House then, mini then. In the next video will be a skinny and a fat boy. So make sure you tune in. Check it all out. And always, always be in a well-ventilated area with a fan on. You can see that. My windows are open. And have a respirator. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. skinny boy. Apparently, I haven't used it yet. It's a very skinny. Skinny tip to put some skinny lines, and then we're gonna do fat boy, which we like to call a fat robot kit, which is a very large spray. We're gonna use a low pressure paint from Montana. Switch these out. What you want to do is dump it upside down. Make sure the nozzle is away from you. You just spray. Okay. We're gonna